So let us continue with semiconductors, part 3. We have done forward bias, reverse biasing, we have done rectifiers which converts AC to DC. That's our IV characteristic. Now let us see what is Zener-diode. Explain its use as a regulator. So the VI, the input fluctuating voltage, which we had got, for example, from a rectifier, can be converted to a constant voltage using a Zener. So a Zener is a heavily doped junction diode which operates in the reverse breakdown region, that is a Zener diode. For wide values of load resistance RL, the current through the Zener may change, but the voltage remains constant. There's a circuit for the voltage regulator using a Zener diode, that's the symbol. So due to the reverse biasing, the electrons are attracted. Covalent bonds are broken due to this force and electrons are removed from the bonds. Depletion layer becomes thin because of these electrons which are available for conduction. This results in a large current. Once Zener breakdown occurs, the voltage is constant even if the current is increased. Breakdown voltage is less than 6 volt, operated in the Zener breakdown region. Breakdown voltage more than 6 volt, operate at the avalanche breakdown region. When current increases, current through the resistance RS and the Zener both increases. This increases the voltage across RS. But voltage across Zener does not change. RS absorbs the voltage fluctuations, hence gets protected. This is the reverse bias characteristic, the breakdown voltage. It is the voltage which breakdown occurs, or is the voltage corresponding to the midpoint of the linear region. Breakdown current is the current corresponding to the midpoint of the linear region. That's the circuit again. The voltage regulator converting fluctuating input into constant DC voltage. The equation involved here, V in low is Vs plus Vz, that is Iz minimum Rs plus Vz. V in high is Vs plus Vz, Iz max Rs plus Vz. The maximum power rating is Vz into Iz max. I should be less than Iz max, which is specified by the manufacturer. If it is more, then heat is generated which damages the Zener. Vz is constant. Therefore, VL or V output voltage across RL is constant even if current changes. Zener diode is used as a voltage regulator, peak clipper or wave shaper and protecting meters. Now let's see what's a photodiode. As the name suggests, photo means light. When light is incident on the PN junction, there is current. This is a symbol. The light enters, as you can see the arrows on the top. That's the schematic structure. The diffusion mask of SiO2 is near the P region. Silicon nitride coating. One part is exposed to light to the glass and the other part is open. On illumination, electron hole pairs are generated in the depletion region only if H nu is greater than the AG. Reverse current depends on the minority carriers and not on the applied voltage. Also, reverse current depends on the intensity of incident light. This is the IV characteristic. Principle of operation of a photodiode. Reverse bias PN junction on illumination generates electron hole pairs in the depletion region provided H nu is greater than AG. Reverse current depends on the minority carriers and intensity of incident light and not on the applied voltage. Dark current. It is the reverse current which depends on the concentration of the minority carriers and not on the applied voltage. It flows even if light does not fall on the photodiode. So that's the dark current. Dark resistance is the ratio of maximum reverse voltage upon the dark current. The total current is the sum of photocurrent and the dark current. So that's the characteristic, current versus the intensity of the light. IR is the device current, that is the reverse current. Saturation current, IS. ID is the dark currents. Advantages of the photodiode: the moment light falls, currents are slowing, operations are fast, IR is directly proportional to the intensity of the incident light, device is small in size and light in weight, responds to large part of the spectrum. Disadvantages: it depends on temperature. If illumination is less, current is less. Some applications are switches and counters, burglars alarm, detecting visible and invisible radiation, fast switching and high speed operations, fire and smoke detectors. Now let's see the principle, construction and the working of a solar cell and see the advantages and uses of a solar cell. So solar cells are also photovoltaic cells. Solar energy is available, pollution free and free of cost. Photothermal devices convert solar energy to heat energy. Photovoltaic devices convert solar energy to electrical energy. The principle of the solar cell: solar energy is directly converted to the electrical energy by the process of photovoltaic conversion, which we have discussed earlier. Construction: the material generally used for solar cells are silicon, germanium and gallium arsenide, cadmium sulfide, etc. A p-n junction is formed when a thin layer of P layer is grown on the N-type semiconductor. So that's the schematic structure: the P side, the N side, base P, anti-reflecting coating, the front contact, the rear contact. So that's the schematic structure: N side faces sun, P side is thick and is at the back, P and N side coated with conducting material, N side coated with anti-reflecting coating to avoid loss. Again, we have the structure here. When the solar radiations fall on the surface, they are absorbed. Two-step process is, when H nu is greater than Eg, that is the incident light, photons are absorbed to produce electron hole pair. They are photo-generated electrons in the P material. There are photo-generated holes in the N-type material. They are spatially separated and prevented from recombination in a solar cell. Separation of carriers are possible due to the intrinsic electric field of the depletion region. They are swept across the junction. Positive and negative charges are thus accumulated on the P region and N region is used as a voltage source. Solar cell is connected to the external circuit. Carrier flows through this circuit. Now, the current from the solar cell is known as light generated current or photo generated current. So that's the IV characteristics or VI characteristic of a solar cell. That's the short circuit current. The short circuit current is the curve meeting the current axis. The open circuit voltage is a curve meeting the voltage axis. In both cases, power delivered is zero. Now there's the Vmax, the Imax, power delivered is maximum, PL is equal to Imax into Vmax. Criteria for selection of the material: Eg should be between 1 EV to 1.8 EV, solar cell generally 1.45 EV. That's the other. Optical absorption should be high, electric conductivity should be good, it should be easily available. Advantages: very little maintenance, lasting long, no pollution. Disadvantage: high installation cost and low efficiency. Uses in telecommunication, railway signaling system, traffic lights, etc. They are used in calculators, watches, battery chargers, and ships, etc. They are used to power satellites, spaceships, etc. Used in defense instruments like mobile telephone, remote radar, etc. So we'll continue next time. Thank you.